joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. So when we commit sin, when we commit sin, what happens to us? It takes away our joy. It takes away the joy of the Lord. What the another danger of sin is that it robs us of our peace. Somebody that is into sin will not have peace of mind. For example, somebody that steals cannot have peace until you finish that thing that you have done. That thing will be pushing you. Hide under the chair. Hide under the bed. Go to the toilet. You will not have peace. But imagine that you have asked mommy or daddy, can I have this? And they say, you can get your chocolate. You don't need to hide to eat it. You don't want to walk on that to eat it. So sin takes away your peace. And as soon as they start looking for that thing, the devil will come to start knocking at the door of your heart. And you are the one that took that thing. And you are the one that you will look your best. Probably mommy keeps her phone here because she said, who took my phone? And you are the one. The devil that pushed you to steal is still the devil that will come and start punishing you again with your conscience. You are the one. 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 That is what the devil does to us. So we don't want to make ourselves a slave to the devil. What's another danger to sin? Prayers are not answered. The Bible says, if I have iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. If we have sin in our lives, God will not listen. Because as soon as we kneel down to pray, the devil will stand up and go and meet God and say, this is your daughter that is praying. This is your son that is praying. Look at. He stole yesterday. He fought yesterday. He slapped someone. He abused. He did this. He did that. He's even doing through the bribery and corruption. Yoruba people will say, Esu, Olufisu, ni Esu. What is the meaning of Olufisu? That is somebody that is always reporting us to God. So this is my take. When you will come and thank me, and then you will still go and report me to God, why should I obey you when you speak to me? Hallelujah. Sin. This is that hinders our fellowship with God. Whenever we are sin, it breaks the relationship that is between us and God. Sin hinders our fellowship with God. God desires to have fellowship with man. God desires to have a close relationship with us. If you remember the story of Adam and Eve at the Garden of Eden, the Bible says that God came down to have fellowship with them. God came down. He's always coming down to have fellowship. But as soon as Eve ate the forbidden fruit, what happened? There was a, you know, it hindered that fellowship. And by the time God came to fellowship with them, their eyes were already open. They went to hide. As soon as Eve ate the fruit and gave it to Adam, and the two of them ate, the Bible says that they saw that they were naked. And that was that it will open your eyes to the wrong things of